I feel about Black Done Right. Now, this is an idea I got from years over time, and so let me tell you a little bit of a rundown I have, where I used to be known for the black person who everybody picks on because he's not living up to the stereotype. He's like, you should love being black, where in actuality, they're acting white. And I'm talking about the people, like, literally, the suburb black kids that are making fun of me because I wasn't on my shit. Like, and what I mean on my shit is that I wasn't on street code, I wasn't on anything, like, literally, and that I wasn't about clownery. And literally, there's a long history I have for literally me and black people, but then I met a real black person, literally, while I started to become black, and his name is Robert. So it happened to be Robert. Is Robert gave me a whole bunch of perspective. He let me come into his backyard, let me smoke weed in his backyard each and every day, and shit like that. Literally, I'm like, why is he so nice to me? And I realized over time, it's because I'm a square, it's because I don't like to get into trouble. He likes that about me. It's more of a grown man than you think. A gang member is more of a grown man than you actually think. They have to do a lot to cope with their situation. They have to put in work. A gang member requires a lot of physical movement, a lot of like maneuvering. It's a really, really, really fast-paced lifestyle. And that's what really keeps them on edge, but that's also what keeps them multidimensional. So it's a different path of life that I learned over time that I'm like, no, I can't do this shit, bro. Like, literally, fucking, like, literally, I can't always be thinking that he's just a hoodlum and nothing else. And like, there has to be something to that. And you know where that comes from? That comes from gang, a six pack, that comes from literally being black, done light, having a soul, being able to dance, being able to do everything, expressing literally what's so more type of dimensional about being black. And that's literally, a lot of people criticize me about that. And I always wanted to be like the sophisticated brothers, you know, and shit like that. But I wasn't having the discipline to become a lawyer and stuff like that. I was wondering, like, literally, because literally, what I imagined myself not was to be like other lawyer. I was so obsessed with time planning. I was joking. My mom and my uncle used to always spam plays in my face. And then I thought about it, and then I went there, and I'm like, you know what, from watching all the information for black people and watching how my mom literally went to college, my goal in life was to get my master's degree. I'm like, okay, then it's concrete. I'm gonna have a state career because I got that from my Tyler Perry film, from this film specifically, but Derek Goes to Jail, how she kept on adding extra years for her school to make sure she made the utmost money and shit. So like, literally, I'm like, dude, when I'm younger, I'm gonna focus on getting my master's degree. And guess what happened when I got older? I forgot. I went out of control of hormones, dropped out of college, ended up coming to internet superstar shit instead. So you get what I'm saying, fucking, but that doesn't take away from my upbringing. So recently, I went literally a little far distance. This is from my mom and Lily. What happened was this, Lily freaking, the bus was about to leave. It was kind of like a Soul Train bus and shit. And so all these freaking faggots fans of mine were Lily stalking me and shit like that, wondering like, Lily, what's the whole point of it? They got why it was cool, but they were wondering, because what was happening is we're going back to the old school black style. We're talking about the Temptations. We're talking about Marvin Gaye. We're talking about this and that. The real, real, real origins of what really made being black beautiful as far as how it got standard today and shit, you know, So literally what happened was this, literally, so I was on the bus and shit, and they were about to leave, and then I put my hand up there, and I run to the front of the bus, and so literally, the black guy who's the typical black guy you probably see at church and shit like that, he was like, yo, and like, literally, we were about to leave, but as soon as he heard his mama wasn't there, he's like, hold up, I gotta stay here for my mama, and this and that, literally, and literally, the black thing, the most beautiful, like, thing, like, and literally, so all the fucking Discord faggots were literally looking through the fucking drawers and stuff like that, and they understood from studying my iPod, but studying the way I do shit, that I'm a fan of being black done right, and I didn't like how literally they made black being pop culture now with fucking heritages and shit, where fucking we can't really express the soul anymore, we have to be a part of this machine society and shit, you know, it's like this lack of expression when it comes to black culture and shit, and literally, this and that, literally, is like, we were really, really about to jet, but he stayed here, wait here for his mama and this and that. And literally, I swear. And literally, just Discord faggots were all like, literally, like, yeah, I get it's really soulful, but like, what's the point? Like, literally, what's the point that the whole purpose of that is dead? I'm like, then why are there so many people on that bus? Like, stuff like that. And those people matter more than you think and stuff like that, literally, freaking. I thought that shit was dead too, but it's still going on. And I'm glad that it's alive. It's still, like, literally, very small compared to where it used to be, but I am 100% a fan of black done right, especially since I remember that I didn't make the same mistake as some of my black borrowers. I didn't just stay with local music that literally my neighbors making shit. shit, I made sure I got up there to a point because I kept on listening to fucking Busta Rhymes, Ludacris, and Eminem. I kept on listening to Black Don Wright, so you couldn't fuck with me on that, Lily. And they kept on settling for less, Lily. I'm just gonna listen to lean rap and fucking fuck bitches rap and nothing else, Lily. No lyrical rap, no rapping about fucking culture, no rapping about buildings and shit like that, Lily. I can show you some rap techniques that Lily gotta make you a better envision of writer and shit. Like, I'm telling you, man, like, I really, really, really was out there. So I got this from a Tyler Perry film, Madea's, you know, Goes to Jail. And I thought about this back when I was younger. I never expected to be like this because I used to be in a lot of people's position, a lot of black people who pretend to be hard, who watch anime. I know how it feels. I'm like, you know, for all black anime fans out there, you gotta get a six pack, man. I'm sorry. There's so much things. I'm not trying to act like an asshole because I have brothers who force sports down my throat and saying that I'll become more multidimensional, that I'll make more friends if I play sports for the exact opposite app. I'm not gonna lead you astray. I'm gonna tell you this right here, right now. You have to get a six pack for your own benefit because you don't see me playing sports, but it expands your mind. It allows you to think faster. It allows you to be quicker on your feet to the point where you can even get tasks done. That shit helps you at work. That shit helps you with everything. It should definitely help me with my YouTube channel. It helped my swagger. It helped everything be up there. Working out is a universal benefit, not just for black people, but for people in general. Lily, you have to work out because it's gonna give you the stamina. It's gonna give you the momentum. It's gonna give you everything, the motivation, everything that you need to get everything done. Like, you gotta understand that, Lily. That is a very good, but there's also other things you gotta play into that too. You also gotta have a healthy mind before you start working out. With this combination of body and mind also comes from meditation. But the main point I want to get with Black Don Wright in this video is that you see how these guys are super yoked with the freaking six packs and shit. And Lily, I thought I never needed to gain one. That's Lily. I used to think, I'm just gonna fucking, you know, drop my complex, fucking, you know, fucking listen to music that fucking I don't even understand, or everybody else is listening to music that they can relate to and shit. I'm just gonna really stay in my own world and fucking not think I have to adapt to the world outside, forgetting that I'm black and shit like that. And this scene, Lily, so you see this guy with dreads, you see how they're both in uniform. This is why it's my favorite play because it gave me a wild perspective even when I was young. So if you watch the movie, if you watch the play, but then it goes to jail, Lily, what happens is, Lily, these guys go through shit after shit after shit. Lily, they were a really bad case. So these two officers are calm, cool, collect throughout the entire movie, and one talks shit to another out of nowhere after both dealing with bullshit, and then these niggas get into a tie-up and their muscles are popping out and shit. I'm like, like, Lily, this is really about to happen because they're so calm, cool, and sophisticated throughout the entire play, and out of nowhere, like, Lily, they go through after a really complex storyline, they get heated, and then they start going arms, Lily. They both get each other with arm locks. You see the muscles popping out. I'm like, damn, I never even think they had it in them, like, Lily, back when I was younger, Lily, on that gay shit, and I was looking at them, Lily, I'm like, oh my fucking god, like, I can't ever be that strong and shit like that. And Lily, I was looking at them, Lily, in the arm, like, after analyzing a very mature situation, these two niggas were going at it. He's like, you know what, nigga, I had enough. But they didn't say, it's like, you know what, man, I had enough. And like, Lily, that's a real black man. The first one is a fake black man, the second one is a real black man. And then these two guys were in the arm, too. I saw them popping out, I'm like, ain't no way, because I saw their six packs before, and then I saw them square up for each other. Lily, they both arm tied each other, and I was really looking at that shit when I was joking. I'm like, I didn't even think that they could do that. I didn't even think that was a part of inside of them. And that's really what is the power of working out. That is, Lily, that's the power of working out, that's the power of being a black man. This scene right here, Lily, I can't play it because YouTube, Lily, doesn't have the full play, but these two characters got into a little arm wrestle and shit. No, I'm talking about they got into a little tangle, Lily. They were on each other. They're like, like a fucking boxing match and shit. Like, Lily, fucking, they were holding off each other shit. Their muscles were popping out. And I used to always think, dude, that shit is scary. Like, Lily, I never even thought they were gonna fight at all and shit like that, Lily. And then I looked at the situation now that I'm older, and now the beauty of actually learning, instead of looking at it as just a play, instead of looking at it as just, oh, they're so fucking scary, they both have six pack and they're both about to knock each other out and shit, instead of looking at it like this, I gotta look at it like this. Damn, I'm one of those niggas now. And it feels so good, I'm trying to let you know. And that is why I'm a big fan of Black Done Right. That's how hard I go, Lily, when it comes to real life. That's how, Lily, how patient I am before you take me, this and that. Like, Lily, that's literally how you got to be when you're a grown man, though. It's a different principle, Lily. That's a part of growing up in general. They are learning that from growing up when they were young, Lily. You don't understand, like, Lily. And you think that shit comes out of nowhere, that they didn't try too hard to fit in. That picture's worth a thousand words. When you see those two black men with six-pack being mature into one day they cross the line, and then they settle it in really a real tight dispute and shit, and they have officer job and shit. They start a job where officers and shit. I saw all that shit. Literally, two officers in a arm lock, literally, in a fucking Tyler Perry film. Something so fucking multi-dimensional, so fucking much perspective. I'm gonna go into Tyler Perry's editing and what makes him one of the best editors of all time, aside from his message, and that's another reason why I love Tyler. I fuck with Tyler tough, but still, man, like, Mac for Syrup, it all good, man. I'm trying to let you know, man, that this is literally the reason why I love Black Done Right. I'm really a big fan of Black Done Right, literally. And my parents are damn near right, basically. I'm still a fan of Black Done Right. My grandma used to always make, literally, my grandma used to make jokes like that. But, Eris, I hang out with more black people than I'm white. But the main part of that is that that means that they did do wrong once. Those two sophisticated black men in the arm lock were both in gangs before, were both this, that, and they let go of the street life in order to live a sophisticated life, like in order to live a healthy, balanced lifestyle. They all gave up that, but that lets you know it's still in them. And that's literally, that's the biggest fucking thing. I learned all that shit now, like, now I'm an adult, and I'm like, dude, it feels so good to be one of them now. It's literally, it feels so good to literally be not out of place. Instead of asking all those gay questions, you live through the experience, you freaking love it, then you can relate to people better. Instead of being a prick, instead of coming off like really trying to be dominant, you learn how to be loving and caring and respectful to people. And that's what I love about, you know, Black Done Right.